What's up, guys? It's Harvey, and I'm here to answer all of your submitted questions.
Dear Harvey, I need a new do. Your hair is always perfectly coiffed. How do you do it? Sincerely, Flatlocks Frank.
Okay, so I'm gonna tweak you through the process of my hair. I wake up in the morning, I have a shower, and then I just blow dry it, but I got like a round comb, and then I blow dry it like that, and then I use a lot of hairspray. So if you want a new do, I think just go on YouTube and like look at some tutorials, but use a lot of hairspray, because this is what gets this up, hairspray.
Dear Harvey, my child is a huge fan of yours and wants to pursue a singing career. Unfortunately, he has no idea he's tone deaf. How do I stay supportive without misleading him? From Far From Future Stage Mum.
Ooh, that's a hard one. I mean, maybe you try and direct him down a different route, but maybe still within like the musical industry. So maybe say that you're good at singing, because obviously he's young, so you don't want to break his heart. You can maybe say you'd be really good at acting. Like, I feel like you'd be a really good actor. When I was about 12, me and my friend, he's called Harry, okay? And at the time he thought he was a really good singer. And he sung to me and my mum, and he sung Beyonce. And I remember trying not to laugh the whole time. And then he said that he was gonna go on Britain's Got Talent. And me and his mum had to try and convince him that maybe he shouldn't. And then, yeah, now he doesn't sing. Now he's an actor, so that's what I'm saying, so.
Dear Harvey, I have a massive crush on a girl at school, but she has no idea I exist. How can I capture her attention without freaking her out? Your friend, Stuck in the Shadows, Steve.
Okay, so I feel like you need some girl advice, so I'm gonna bring one of my good friends in. Lauren, come on in. Lauren is gonna give you some advice. Go ahead.
Okay, Steve. I would say, personally, just be yourself. Put yourself out there a little bit more. Try to hang around her a bit more, you know. Get a little in her grill, but not too much to freak her out. So be yourself, be confident. She's gonna love you.
But he might be friend-zoned if he gets too, like, friendly and pally
with her. Then you're meant to be friends.
Dear Harvey, I was accepted to a university 4 hours from home. Problem is, my boyfriend is still in secondary school. I'm afraid that if I move away, our relationship will suffer. What should I do? XOXO, not ready to graduate, Greta.
Just go and leave and pursue your dreams and all that kind of stuff, because you're still too young to worry about like relationships just yet. And 4 hours is not that bad, you know? Like, I'm sure you guys can meet each other like in the middle maybe, but I definitely feel like you should just go for it and go and leave.
I would say go, but if you care about him, stay in contact, and if it doesn't work out, there are plenty of fish in the sea, especially if you're going to college.
Dear Harvey, my friend's social media following has been skyrocketing, and he's starting to let it go to his head. How do I tell him to chill without offending him? Best, more to life than likes.
Offend him, like bring him back down to earth. If you need to offend the kid, then you gotta do it. Like, there's no nice way of saying it. I feel like, yeah.
Just offend him.
Just go for it. Like, no offense, but like offense taken kind of thing.
Yeah.
I feel like if you get popular on the internet, I suppose it does go to your head a little bit if it happens very quickly. So I think there have been certain people, but I feel like as friends, we've brought them back down to the ground again.
Eventually, they come back down.
Yeah.
Yeah. Eventually.
Dear Harvey, my girlfriend gets a lot of flirtatious comments on Instagram, and I can't help but be jealous. It's frustrating. What would you do? Signed, Lurking for Love in All the Wrong Places.
I take it as a huge compliment, because if other people think that your girlfriend's cute and hot and they're flirting, then it means that you've done good. So I wouldn't get mad. I'd be happy, you know? She obviously likes you, that's why she's with you.
You should trust her enough to know that she loves you, she'll stay with you despite the flirtatious comments.
Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed our amazing advice. I feel like it was pretty good. If you want to watch more of us, then make sure you go check out my music video, Personal, featuring Lauren. She's in it. So yeah, go watch it. Go tell us what you think. And we'll see you later.
So what if somebody that you know well is like creeping real hard though on the comments?
That's different.
Yeah, I mean, if you know them quite well, then I feel like you're going to have to DM them.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? You've got to go straight in for it. Yeah, send him a message like, look, pal, you're getting too close to my girl. I appreciate the lovely comments, but can we reel them in a little bit?
Or just have her delete them until they get annoyed, and then eventually it'll stop.
Or just block him.
Off her account?
Yeah, just go onto her account and block him. or her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe ask her how she feels, and depending on her response, that's how you should act.
Yeah. I'd say block, but yeah.